the hammer.
That is so good. You always say that.
Because it is. Well, you have to start showing your work again.
You always say that.
I'm not ready. And you always say that.
Any word on the audition?
Nothing yet. Well, it's only been one day. Aaron, 45 minutes to your econ class.
Morning, sis. Do I smell bacon?
You need an A on that test.
I just get one.
All right, smell bacon. Now eat up. We don't have a lot of time.
Stew. Allie, I thought we paid these.
We did. We just didn't pay these.
Why didn't you tell us?
She's protecting us, which you don't have to do anymore. Look, we'll dig our way out of this. We always do. With my tips and Christmas bonus.
And mine.
I'll take an extra shift.
We're the Evans, right? We're the Evans.
It's good to see you getting loose a bit.
Don't get used to it. We're heading home. What does my day look like? Let me guess. Back-to-back meetings, greetings, and eatings.
You have a breakfast with the charity board, a post-breakfast with the foundation, and then overnight in London for the children's hospice. Unfortunately, with your permission, you'll have to spend a day without me.
What for?
Yet another governess, that's it.
It's only been 2 days.
Long days, apparently. And with the Christmas gala coming up, it looks like I'll have to hire one here.
Good idea. New Yorkers are impervious to pain. Make sure that housekeeping get a generous tip.
Yes, of course.
you to do that.
Just a couple more sweets.
I got this.
Thanks, sis. I owe you one.
I'll add to the list.
Break a leg.
Housekeeping.
In the room.
Your father's watch. I'll get it for you, sir.
Why hasn't this been done? The room is still a mess.
I'm sorry. I need another 15 minutes, 20 minutes tops.
Leslie Nelson Carroll
has been waiting downstairs for nearly half an hour. Do you know who she is?
Someone with three first names?
Oh, she writes the hotel review for the Times. And she asked for an early check-in.
I'm sorry.
Leave your keys. You can pick up your check downstairs.
You firing me? A week before Christmas.
No. I'm firing you and your sister. A week before Christmas.
Here. Someone left a watch in the dresser.
I just feel terrible. This is all my fault.
We'll get something else.
During the holidays?
We'll figure it out.
Hey, sis. This is Mr. Fergus McDuffin.
Fergus will suffice.
But this is about all the overdue bills.
I beg your pardon.
He's a butler from
Windsor. We're a sovereign nation near Luxembourg. My employer is aware of your untimely dismissal from the hotel. In the spirit of Christmas, and for returning his watch, he'd like to give you this.
Oh, wow! $5,000?
Thank you. But as much as we could use this, we can't accept.
Yes, we can.
It's too much. But thank you anyway.
Well, I have to say, I find that quite...
ridiculous?
Admirable. I didn't mean to ask it, but is that mulligan stew I smell?
You know it?
I know it. Everything in the kitchen...
Plus cheese.
So I haven't had it since I was a boy.
Would you like to join us for dinner? So, what do you think?
Even better than I remember.
Allie can make cardboard taste good.
And we have.
Your parents raised you well.
Actually, they passed away when we were young.
Oh, sorry.
Allie raised us. She dropped out of art school to come home.
And I'm still raising you, even though you're both adults.
It's very noble.
Oh, you have no idea. These two were holy terrors.
Hey!
You know, I have an idea. Perhaps you accept this check. That's 2 weeks' wages for a job in winter.
You want me to go to Europe to clean someone's house?
Well, I wouldn't call it a house, and you wouldn't be cleaning it. A governess unexpectedly left. As it happens, I'm looking for a filling over the holidays.
A governess? Like Mary Poppins?
Yes, but without the umbrella and bottomless bag. You'd be in charge of one little girl.
But I'm a total stranger.
Exactly. 31, never married, not in a current relationship, dwindling bank balance, former employment, sales clerk, waitress, dog walker.
You had me checked out?
I'm afraid I wouldn't be here otherwise. You see, the family is very prominent and very discreet. You'll be flown first class, of course, and have your own apartments and ladies' maid.
She'll take it.
Eliza, this morning you were a maid, and now you'll have one.
You'll be stuck here forever.
It'll be an adventure.
But it's Christmas.
We'll do Christmas in January.
What? We could use the money. Can we just have the night to think about it?
Of course. And if your answer is yes, I'll send a car for you in the morning.
Thank you.
Well, thank you again for a delicious and most unexpected dinner.
Oh,
good night.
Good night.
So?
Christmas.
See you.
Love you.
See you.
Too.
And Eliza.
island town?
Here it is.
It's like a castle.
Because it is a castle. It's been in the family for 3 centuries.
What kind of family is this?
A royal one. You'll be looking after Princess Theodora, the daughter of King Maximilian III of Windsor.
And you're just telling me this now?
Discretion is of the utmost importance. The palace wouldn't want it getting out that they're employing yet another infamous.
How many have there been?
Let's say the princess can be a bit of a handful.
That many, huh? What a warm greeting.
Yes. Tragically, it's not for you. At the service entrance, please, Thomas.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
This way.
Ladies, this is Miss Evans, our new governess. This is Claiborne, our cook, and Miss Wick, our head housekeeper. She'll show you to your quarters.
Welcome, Miss Evans.
Allie, please.
We use formalities here, Miss Evans.
Sorry. Hi.
Carter, take the new governess's bags to her room.
Yes.
Follow me. I'm sure you'll want to change into something more appropriate.
Like a museum.
Don't touch anything.
Sorry.
We adhere to a strict schedule, especially during Christmas. Are you familiar with court protocol?
I want you down to Abbey.
Fergus will give you a schedule, and I'll have your uniform sent up. You won't see much of His Royal Highness, and I can almost guarantee you won't see you. These are your quarters. This is all mine. I wouldn't get too attached. Chances are you won't make it to Christmas.
You to give her a check, not a job.
She wouldn't take it.
Why not?
I believe she considered it a handout. I realize that she's not the conventional choice, but then again, we haven't had much luck with convention. You've always trusted my decisions, Max.
Why don't I feel that same trust right now?
I can't imagine.
Fergus, a moment, please.
Certainly, Chancellor.
I trust you had an enjoyable holiday.
It's hardly a holiday.
Your hotel bill says otherwise. I don't need to remind you that your popularity is down, as well as our finances.
I suppose that's what happens when no one in the family's had a job for 1,000 years.
Your father had no time for frivolity.
Yes, I remember.
Well, now that you're back, might I suggest that we focus on Christmas Eve? The gala would be the perfect opportunity for an announcement.
I'm not ready.
Thank you.
sworn I heard somebody knocking on my door. So weird. Hey! Thanks for the snake. I've given it some thought, and I've decided I don't need a governess. Well, I don't blame you. Lucky for you, I'm not a real governess. What are you? An A-looker. And I don't need one of those either. Are you sure about that? That snowball toss out there was pretty weak. Pretty weak? You almost missed me. Could you do better?
With both hands behind my back.
Prove it. No hands. Through the door.
Into each other in New York.
Allison Evans, Ali.
His Highness is not in the habit of shaking hands.
You may as well send her packing now. Save us all the tedious getting to know one another.
Off to the room, Theodora. Miss Evans.
Excuses, but you are my first king.
Yes, I believe that's quite apparent.
I'm afraid Theodora's behavior is my fault, Miss Evans. My royal duties preclude me from spending much time parenting her.
As they should, Your Highness, if I may. The princess is a rebellious child who prides herself on terrorizing those in authority. They've all tried, without success, to understand her behavior.
Well, she is 10.
She's a princess. And is expected to act like one at all times. Is that clear?
With all due respect, sir, childhood is a short season. If you try and make her grow up too fast, she just might do it.
Miss Evans, are you trying to get fired?
No one's being fired, Chancellor. Miss Evans, you will supervise Theodora to all the royal events, but kindly stay in the background.
In other words, be invisible.
Somehow I doubt you're the invisible type. That'll be all.
Tough room. Who's the pageant man?
Chancellor Riggs, advisor to the throne. I suggest you stay in his good books.
Is he always so...
insufferable?
Well, can he use another word?
I'll have someone sent to your room.
Not even with everyone else?
The governesses usually keep to themselves.
We're looking at this picture right now. I cannot believe that it's the same guy you hit with the maid cart.
Oh, nice driving, sis.
He's a guy. He's a king. And I also hit him with a Christmas ornament.
So it's going well, then?
Not to mention the little girl. She's exactly like you guys were.
Oh, no.
Good luck. Oh, gotta go. Come in. You were so fun. Thank you.
We don't tip here.
Gotcha. Sorry. What's for dinner? Hi. Huh.
Don't you, boy? It's a trick we've been working on.
It's the first smile I've seen since I got here. Well, I should get back to my overly large room.
You know, it's not often people speak their mind around here.
Sorry.
Don't be.
I'm not gonna try to curtsy again, if that's okay.
Good night, Miss Evans. You like it, don't you?
Here. The king was just to go away, pushing around, causing trouble, but, you know, in a good way. It was always the fun royal. But then fate stepped in.
Thank you. What happened to Theodore's mother?
She took ill. It was a long battle, and soon after he lost his father in a riding accident. It was dreadful. I mean, poor Maximilian. He suddenly found himself thrust into the role of widower. And king. And all before his 30th birthday. I don't think he's met anyone or anything in since.
Good morning, Theodora. It's still here. I don't scare off that easily. I suppose this is when you start trying to turn me into a little princess. I don't have nearly enough time to do that. Besides, when I was your age, the last thing I wanted to be was a princess. What did you want to be? An artist. Well, why didn't you? Well, good enough. Something like that. So, what do you want to do? You're letting me decide. It's your castle. Do you like this one? Yeah, it looks kind of like you. You're not afraid of bugs.
Are you kidding? New York has the toughest cockroaches in the world.
My last governess was scared of bugs. She also said I was annoying.
All kids are annoying. That's their job.
How old are you?
How old do you think I am?
60.
Close. 31.
Are you married?
Nope.
No one ever asked?
Well, someone asked once. At sixth grade.
Are you an old maid?
Well, I'm a maid. I mean, I was a maid. I mean, I was fired. Not anymore.
Are you here just because you want to marry my father?
I'm not a woman, Jane.
That's why they're nice to me.
Well, you can rest assured. If I'm nice, it's because I like you. And I'm more likely to marry Santa Claus than your father.
Santa Claus is already married.
As he should be. This is a great greenhouse.
It was my mother's. People say I look a lot like her.
I'm with Mr. Leon.
Yes.
You know, I lost my mom, too. And my dad. Back home, when things get tough, my brother and sister and I put our hands together and we say, we're the Evans. It makes us feel like we can get through anything.
So, are the Evans special?
We're just a regular family.
Do you think we
to put a few in the switch bed. That sounds like an Ellie to me.
Is that Ellie? Oh, there you are. Theodora is late for the Christmas photograph.
What?
I left a schedule under your door.
I didn't get any schedule. She'll be ready in 5 minutes.
Make it 4.
We had the 3-minute rule. My roommate barely made that. In fact, a toast. If there is Christmas in your heart, then there is most definitely Christmas in the air.
Perhaps you'd like to add a toast of your own, Miss Evans.
It's considered unlucky to toast without a glass.
Fergus, would you get a glass for Miss Evans, please? I'm on for yourself.
Scrooge my yards. Thank you.
Thanks, Merry Christmas to those who've seen us at our best and at our worst and can't tell the difference.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Well said, Miss Evans.
Down there, just in front of the mirror.
Me and Miss Evans decorate the tree.
The royal decorator. in charge of the tree. You schedule in tomorrow.
Get a head start. Please.
Oh, I suppose you could put up a few things.
At least until Miss Wick takes them down. That's it. Straight up there in front of the mirror.
The ornaments are locked up. But I know where the key is. Or we could make our own. Why would we want to do that? Come with me. This old place looks great. And so do those pine cones. A little gold paint and some ribbon. Well, I challenge any royal decorator to outdo this. My mum used to decorate the tree with me. Mine too. I'm starting to forget what she was like. You know what I do when I feel like that? I think hard about one memory, like the last time we were together. What was that? Christmas. A lot of years ago. We were opening presents, and we all sang, Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer, which is a pretty twisted song. I couldn't stop laughing. That's what I think about it. And it all comes back.
Have you come to a decision? Yes. I'm postponing it indefinitely. Maximilian, you've had 4 years to grieve. A royal wedding was still in the country. Lady Celia's family is a crucial link to our relations with the northern provinces.
I'm sure we can find another link whose chain isn't attached to an arranged marriage.
She's beautiful, she's educated, and she's royal.
She's perfect in every way.
Exactly. And you have history together. Now do not run off to school in America and meet someone else. We wouldn't be...
But I did. I like Celia. But I don't love her, and I'm not sure that I ever will.
What should needs a queen? Not to mention Theodora could use a mother figure. May I remind you, your duty is to your country, not to your heart.
Where have I heard that before?
Your father was a great king!
So I've been told.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, go! But darling, you think this? Beautiful. Oh, thank you, darling. I know what we can use for the top of the tree. I'll be right back. Okay? Miss Evans, what exactly is going on here? Decorating? Apparently. How about this for the top of the tree? Is that your father's crown?
His Royal Highness will not be happy.
Thank you. Here. I'm a butterfly. Wait, I want to give it to you. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen. On Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To be continued.
I think the decorations are absolutely wonderful.
Yes, absolutely superb. See, as my little girl, I bought enough for a vintage champagne.
Yes.
Mind
if I join you guys?
It's not customary for the governess to eat with staff.
I think that's up to Fergus, don't you?
I see no harm in one more.
I'll try not to eat too much.
Trust me. With Mrs. Claiborne's kidney pie, you won't.
I think that's your second piece, isn't it, Fergus?
Is it really?
Be okay.
Fergus tells me you'll make a delicious mulligan stew.
Oh, yes. I had more than one portion of that.
Would you like to give me the recipe tomorrow?
I love you.
I'll drink to that. Cheers, everyone.
Theodora should have her style. And it's too high up in his wig to take down.
Unless she flies up on her broom.
Good point. I know you talk to horses. Do you ride them?
A few times. Around Central Park.
This part's a little bigger. And quieter.
Thanks.
You know, you can only see so much from the back of a limo. You can see everything from the seat of a horse.
You ride every night?
It's the only time when I really feel like myself. I think that's why I love New York so much. Nobody knows me there. I can stand in line, get shouted at by taxi drivers.
That's what you want?
You'd be surprised what you want, but you can't have it.
We should swap lives. I stand in line and get yelled at on a daily basis.
You're in that other way from New York. Her family was royal and stuffy as mine, she wasn't. You lived.
Vegas.
Niagara Falls. My father would disown me if he could. He's a much better king than he was a father.
I probably shouldn't say this.
No, please. Yeah.
Do you ever feel like maybe you've become a little like him?
I'm afraid I might be going down the same path.
Paths change all the time.
Not in my world. Lucas tells me you're an artist.
Oh, he saw a few paintings at my house, that's all.
That's not how he described me.
I had a show once, a couple years back. It didn't go so well. So, now I just paint for myself.
That's a shame. I'd really like to see your work. So would he. What are your manners? There's an artist in the presence.
You taught him that?
He's taught me a few things too.
Change of plan.
Good morning, Mrs. Claiborne. Gingerbread cookies.
Good morning, dear. And how was the rest of your evening?
Just another night in the castle. It's funny, I
can't remember the last time the king took anyone riding. On second thoughts, yes, I can. Never.
Theodora, I saw your father riding last night. Next time, don't hold on to the saddle horn. Thank you. Should there be a next time? I won't.
Good morning, Your Highness.
Morning, Fergus.
Chancellor, your breakfast.
Three,
and changing. Not only green when summer's here, but also red, open here. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, such pleasure do you bring me.
What wonderful acoustics in here.
Not the original German.
A Christmas song is a Christmas song. A royal car has arrived, Your Highness. We're expecting someone. It's not on the schedule.
Oh, that must be Lady Celia.
But you're not arriving until the day of the ball.
I invited her a few days early. After all, she'll be family soon.
That's not your decision.
Someone has to make one, but not like he needs a queen.
Announcing Lady Celia of Luxembourg.
Maximilian, isn't this all just wonderful?
Words cannot describe it.
Theodora, I haven't seen you since you were tiny.
No, you saw me 3 months ago. Under Easter. And last year at the Christmas Gala.
I suppose I should remember these things. But I did remember this.
Thank you. I'll open it on Christmas.
Oh, well, open it now, dear. I can't wait to see it on you.
Ballet. My favourite thing.
Oh, and you're just the right age to start lessons. You are going to make an adorable ballerina.
Lady Celia. This is Miss Evans, my governess. Nice to meet you, Lady Celia.
An American governess? How odd.
I couldn't agree more.
Well, let's all move to the drawing room, shall we, Your Highness?
How is she? The horrible lady my father's supposed to marry.
What better place to announce it than the Christmas Gala?
How perfect. I vote for a spring wedding.
Of what year?
Aren't you silly? This year, of course. We'll send the invitations out on the first. That way it gives anyone who counts plenty of time to get their schedule.
But the wedding has been out of the castle, I assume.
Just as Maximilian's father was. And perhaps the honeymoon in the Maldives?
I'm planning my honeymoon, too.
Our honeymoon? And I adore the Maldives. Unless, of course, you prefer somewhere else.
Father, you don't look too well. Maybe you should go to bed. I'll take you.
I'm fine, Theodore.
It is better night. You must be very tired, Theodora.
Oh, I never sleep. In fact, if you were to get married, you'd never be alone together, because I'd always be there, day and night.
Theodora.
But I have questions for Lady Celia.
Questions?
Do you like rocks?
As long as they're in the ground, I suppose.
Do you know how to make ornaments out of pine cones on Willigan's tree?
You do it, that's enough.
Are you being nice to me just because you want to marry my father? Do you even love my father?
You do
it. Teddy.
Excuse me. Your Highness.
Let the governess
handle it. Your Highness.
Theodora, come out this minute. She's already from the outside. You're looking heavier, darling.
I'm going to break a window, Your Highness.
Still, Max. Can I believe everything you're thinking?
You don't know what I'm thinking.
But I loved you if you wanted to kiss you when I'm meant to be getting married.
So you do know what I'm thinking.
Can I just explain?
There's nothing to explain.
This union was arranged by the throne.
I knew the throne.
No, I just isn't. Apparently the monarchy's only popular when you're getting married and having babies. Celia and I were meant to be married years ago, but we see each other occasionally. It's just always been assumed that we'd be together.
You make a beautiful couple. And I hope that you'll be happy.
Inside, Theodora.
You're not going to punish me?
Hello, everyone, and welcome again. It's hard to believe another year's gone by. I hope it's been a good one for all of you. I tell my daughter many things, most of which she ignores. Theodora, would you please hang a royal ornament on the tree?
I'll hang this one instead.
Sweet.
Something for your Highness.
Look at us, just like a family already.
Miss Wick, I didn't make the bed.
It's a mistake.
May I come? Of course.
What a surprise. To what do I owe the pleasure of this unexpected visit?
You and Maximilian seem rather chummy.
Well, we do go way back. 5 days ago.
I'm just the governess.
An apology, Miss Evans. Actually, I'm quite insecure when it comes to Maximilian. We were supposed to be married years ago. This is my second chance, and I'd hate for him to slip away again.
You have nothing to worry about from me.
The truth is, I don't believe he's ever been quite comfortable as a royal. Or a king. Perhaps you could put a good word in with Theodora for me.
Of course.
I'm glad we had this chat.
Well done, guys.
girls. Ooh, these look delicious.
Can we make more?
Sure. But this time, you're going to do the measuring. All right, 1 3/4 cup of sugar, the 1 cup is being used. So we'll use 7/4 cups because 4 quarters is the same as 1.
Is that like fractions? I don't get all this math stuff.
Oh, it's easy. It's just different ways of saying the same thing. So 1 cookie is the same as 2 halves, which is the same as 4 quarters.
See? That is pretty easy. So if I add 2 quarters, that makes a half.
Yes.
If I add 1 more quarter, that makes 3 quarters. And 3 more quarter makes the whole.
You got it.
If I add another 3 quarters, that would be...
Okay, that's enough math, you little sugar monster. That's almost dinner time.
Toast. To the future, good winter.
To us. Miss Evans and I made Christmas cookies. Who wants one?
I do. Delicious.
Don't you want one, Eddie Celia?
Of course I do.
Is Evans' family recipe?
Is there no end to your times?
There most definitely is.
Well, you certainly have a way with children.
Thank you.
Well, perhaps you have some advice for Maximilian and I. After all, we do plan on having a few of our own, don't we?
I don't have much to add.
Miss Evans says that you should never yell at the child. If you're angry, just lean in and whisper quietly. It's scarier.
That was more of a joke.
Miss Evans says that good parenting lies somewhere between don't do that and what the heck.
All right, Theodore, I think
we
get the picture.
Oh, no, do please go on. This is fascinating.
Miss Evans? Well, I guess if I had advice, it would be always kiss your children goodnight, even if they're asleep.
Well, I think it's safe to say that Miss Evans will be very hard to replace.
Fortunately, she won't be replaced. The daughter won't be needing a governess after all the days.
Really?
Oh. You didn't tell her.
Tell me what?
Your father and I have been discussing your enrollment at Le Rosy.
For sending me to boarding school.
Nothing's been decided yet. Theodora! I asked you not to say anything.
We can't keep replacing governess. You were only 8.
I went to Switzerland when I was Theodora's age. It is a wonderful training ground for young ladies. We can always visit her, and she'll come home on holidays.
I lost my mum. Now I'm losing my father. To her.
You won't lose him, Teddy.
They're sending me away. He's going to forget all about me.
He won't. You are pretty darn unforgettable. No matter how it seems right now, I promise you, you are his crowning achievement. I know this is hard, but you can get through anything.
Just like the event, right?
Christmas Eve, another gala. Mm.
This one will prove unforgettable, I'm sure. I think Lady Celia would be quite happy with this.
It's my mother's ring.
And she would have wanted it on Celia's hand.
It belonged on the hand of Theodora's mother.
Well, if you'd had a long wedding instead of eloping, would have been. But let's look to the future, Maximilian.
Believe me, I'm trying.
I can assure you, it's the right thing to do.
Happy Christmas Eve! his engagement.
He's proposing?
To Lady Celia of Luxembourg.
What? When did this happen?
Apparently, before they were born.
Sorry.
It's okay. Gotta go. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I think I'll use that as my special memory.
Okay. Tiara or no tiara?
No tiara.
Alright, tiara it is.
Young ones, I wore it to a very special dance. A very handsome man, years ago.
It's beautiful.
Well, my mother was a seamstress. She spent months making it.
But I can't possibly.
You can, and you will.
Thank you, Mrs. Claiborne.
It's Helen.
Allie.
Go on, hurry up and get it on before the ball is over.
handsome man.
Oh, you were far too young, I'm afraid. He was in the army and he was sent away. We just lost touch.
You never saw him again?
Oh, yes, I saw him. But by then I was married and my husband passed, so too much time. Anyway, at my age, thoughts of romance are about as unlikely as an eclipse of the moon.
You do realize there are several eclipses every year.
Announcing His Royal Highness King Maximilian and the Princess Theodora.
May I have the first dance?
She really is rather beautiful.
She's very sweet.
Yes.
Lady Celia, for a dance, of course.
Seems you're the only one who hasn't danced.
Fergus hasn't.
I think I'd rather dance with you.
Your judgment is obviously impaired.
It has been for some time.
Thank you.
remember this for the rest of my life.
So will I.
She looks lovely.
As did you once, I recall.
Not blind.
Celia.
I know you don't love me. At least not like you used to. And I'm okay with that for now. Because I think one day you will.
But that's enough for you.
We're going to have a wonderful marriage. Please, just give us a chance. Now, let's take a peek at that ring.
Is it bad luck to see before the proposal?
I'll take the rest.
That's strange, wasn't it?
Oh, when did you last see her?
Early this evening, my study.
Oh, I hate to state the obvious.
I trust my staff implicitly. They've been with me for years.
Not all of them.
And Miss Wick came from your staff.
Well, I'm not talking about Miss Wick.
That's ridiculous.
Is it?
She's not a thief.
I know you're fond of her, but what do you really know about her?
Excuse me, Alice. A few pictures will need you and I'll just be good for relations. Can't you see him?
There you are. Judy. What's that for? Hey, Sylvia. Can I have a word? Between bites. Of course. It appears my engagement ring is missing. Really? That's awful. Yes, I thought you might be able to shed some light on the situation before it escalates any further. Me? No? I have no light to shed. Because there will be a room search. And if it's found amongst your things, the authorities will be called. What are you trying to say? I think it's fair. Be clearer. Well, last week you were a maid. Now you're a governess. Where will this dazzling Clive Ballard land? A 19-carat diamond can buy a whole new life. I have a life. Do you? Look, I might be a lot of things, but I have never taken anything in my life. She doesn't steal. She's an Evans. Thank you, Tate. But I think it might be best if I just leave. You can't. You have another week.
I think under the circumstances, Miss Evans, leaving now would be best. Excuse me.
It's all my fault. I've ruined everything.
Give me the ring, Teddy.
I just didn't want Father to put it on her finger. It was me, and you can stay.
I can't stay, sweetie. I've got enough trouble as it is.
What's going on?
The ring's been found.
So I've seen.
I'm sorry, Father.
Do me a favor. Tell him it was me. It's important that Theodora and Lady Celia get off to a good start.
It was found on my dresser where I left it.
Judge of character.
I was right to hire you and I do it again.
dreamed that halfway around the world, I'd make such good friends. I'm gonna miss you.
Traditional night before Christmas speech, which you've no doubt memorized by now. But tonight, I would like to say something else. Christmas is a time to come together. It's about family, giving, love. And recently, I've come to realize that while I am your king, first and foremost, I am a parent. I know this realm needs a queen, but right now my daughter needs a father. I know many of you were expecting a wedding announcement, and I hope that one day soon you'll have that. But not tonight. I'm sorry. Merry Christmas, everyone. Enjoy the ball. Celia, please, wait.
No, I've waited long enough for
you. Listen, you deserve more than an arrangement. We both do. I really am very sorry. I hope one day we can get past this.
I'm going to show you, we won't. And frankly, I believe I've spent the rest of my life with that child.
That child is my daughter. And unlike you, one day she will be queen.
Do you have any idea what you've just done?
Yes, I do. This is my house, my family. Who I marry and when is my decision.
Your father will be so disappointed.
I can live with that, and if you can't, you can leave.